Hello everyone and thanks for joining. MicroCentra Customer Syndication Extension allows you to integrate your own business logic into the syndication flow, like adding claims from external database into security tokens or customizing verification emails sent by Microsoft Entra ID. You define the business logic in a web API you develop. I'm Yolo, with a product manager with the Microsoft Identity Product Group. This video explains how to configure Customer Syndication Extension without writing traditional code by using Azure Logic Apps. Azure Logic Apps empower users to build workflows using a visual designer. I will demonstrate how to customize verification emails. However, this approach is applicable for all types of customer syndication extensions.
Microsoft Entra ID allows you to add your own business logic at specific events with single syndication flow using customer syndication extensions. When an event is triggered, Microsoft Entra makes an HTTP call to the web API endpoint where you define your custom business logic. For example, the onOTP send event happens when Microsoft Entra is about to send a verification code to the user's email. It allows you to customize the verification message using your preferred mail relay service with your own email template. Let's start with a quick demo. Navigate to woodgrovedemo.com. Select the sign-in button, which will take you to the Microsoft Entra External ID sign-in page. To create a new account, select No Account, Create One link. Then enter your email address. At this point, the onOTP send event is triggered, and Microsoft Entra invokes the Web API Woodgrove configured. The Web API sends a verification code to the email you entered. Here is an example of the customized email sent by Woodgrove. To continue, copy the code and enter it on the signup page. Then select Next. That's it. Now that the concept of the customer syndication extension has been explained, let's proceed to discuss the development of such a web API by using Azure Logic Apps without writing code. A workflow in Logic Apps is a series of steps that automates tasks and processes and can function as a web API. A workflow always begins with a trigger, which is an event or condition that specifies when the workflow should start. In this scenario, it will start on incoming HTTP request, and it is followed by one or more actions, like sending a notification and returning an HTTP response. When a customer syndication extension event is triggered, it makes an HTTP call to the workflow. The HTTP request payload contains details about the event, like the user ID or email address. You can use this information later in the next steps of the workflow. Then you add some actions like sending an email to the user or, for custom claims provider, get the user attributes from a database. Finally, add an HTTP response action that returns an HTTP message to Microsoft Entra ID with an action type that instructs Microsoft Entra how to proceed. The access to the web API should be restricted that only Microsoft Entra can invoke it. Therefore, the call to the web API includes a security token that must be validated by the Azure Logic App. With that in mind, let's begin by creating an Azure Logic App. Go to portal.azure.com and sign with your admin account. Search and select Logic Apps. On the Logic App page, select Add. Select one of the standard hosting options. On the Basic tab, select your Azure subscription. Select a resource group where the Logic App and its related resources will be created. You can also create a new one. Enter a name for your Logic App. The name must be globally unique. Choose a region for your Logic App. Then a service plan that defines the set of compute resources for the Logic Apps to run. Finally, select the pricing plan. More settings are available to you. However, for this demo, leave the default settings and select Review and Create. After Azure validates your Logic App settings, select Create. On the deployment completion page, you can select Go to Resource or select the Logic App from the search box. The next step is to create a workflow in the Logic App. From the list of Logic Apps, select the one you created. On the Logic App menu, select Workflows. Then select Add and choose the Add option. Enter a meaningful name for your workflow. You can choose either stateful or stateless workflow. For non-production environment, choose a stateful option. It can help you to solve technical issues. The new workflow will appear on the list. Select it. On the designer surface, select Add Trigger. Find the request trigger, and then select when a HTTP request is received. The name of the request trigger determines the URL of your Web API endpoint, so change it to something like Web API. The URL of the Web API will be generated after you save the changes. The Customer Syndication extension makes an HTTP POST request to the workflow, so select the POST method. For the request body JSON schema, select Use Sample Payload to generate schema. This enables you to extract data from the request payload. Copy the request payload sample from our documentation. Paste the JSON and select Done. Minimize the Properties window by clicking anywhere on the designer surface. Then click on the plus button and select Add an Action. This is where you configure your business logic. In this example, you send a custom verification email. In the case of custom claims provider, this is where you fetch the user's profile from a database. Search and select Send Email. In this example, I use Azure Communication Email, which I previously configured. If you choose a different mail relay service, the configuration may vary slightly. On the first time you use Send Email action, you need to provide connection details of the Azure Communication Service. Start by entering a connection name. To get the key, go to the Azure Communication Service and under Keys, copy the connection string and add it to the connection string. Then select Create New. After configuring the connection, you can proceed to configure the email message. Enter the from email address, like do not reply to woodgrove.com. Under the To, select the Add New Item button. Then, in the To field, select the option to add items from previous steps. The identifier attribute in the request payload contains the user email address. Select it. Add the subject of the email. Construct the body of your mail. Then, select the option to add data from previous steps and choose one-time code. This attribute contains the verification code. You can add more actions as needed. For example, log the request or update the database with the user's details. Finally, after you add the action to send email, continue to return data back to Microsoft Entra. Under the email action, click on the Add button and select the Add Action option. From the list of actions, select the response action. Make sure the response status is 200. Add an HTTP header content type and set its value to application/json. For the body, add the response JSON provided in our documentation. And insert an extra at sign before each existing sign. Your workflow is ready. Save it. Next, register the Customer Syndication extension in Microsoft Entra ID. Start by copying the URL of the Web API endpoint. To do so, select the request trigger and copy the URL. Next, go to Microsoft Entra Admin Center at entra.microsoft.com and sign in with your admin account. From the menu, select External Identities and then Customer Syndication Extensions. Select Create a Custom Extension. In the Basic tab, select Email OTP Send Event Type and select Next. In the Endpoint Configuration, enter a name, for example, Custom Verification Email. For the target URL, paste the URL of your Web API. Make sure to remove the SIG query string parameter. In Azure Logic Apps, this parameter is used to authenticate requests to the Logic Apps HTTP endpoint. However, Microsoft Entra uses OS2 bearer token instead. Add a description for your Customer Syndication extension and select Next. As we explained earlier, Microsoft Entra ID uses OS2 Client Credentials Grant Flow to issue a security token to securely access your Web API. Under the API authentication, you have two options to set this up. If you have already registered such an application and the Web API endpoints are published under the same domain name, it can be reused. This approach allows you to define multiple Web APIs in your Azure Logic Apps. However, if this is your first one, select Create New App Registration and enter a name. And select Next. Select the application to associate with the Customer Syndication extension. So when a user signs up for this application, the Customer Syndication extension will be triggered. Then select Next to add the apps. And select Next and Create. This registers a customer syndication extension and the associated applications. After your customer syndication extension is created, you will be taken to the overview page. Under the API syndication, if the grant permissions option appears, it means that you need to grant the customer syndication extension credentials application permissions. Select the grant permissions button. The payload to the web API contains sensitive information, so only global administrator can complete this step. Take a note of the API syndication app ID. You will need it soon to configure the Logic App syndication. You also need a tenant ID, so select the application. From the overview page, copy the tenant ID and construct the issuer URI. It differs between workforce tenant and external tenants as detailed in our documentation. The last step is to protect access to the web API, ensuring that only the authorized application you registered earlier with the customer syndication extension can access your workflow. Go back to the Azure Logic App, then select Properties and select the Logic App where the workflow is managed. This configuration is done at the Logic App level, and it will affect all of its workflows. Select Authentication, and then select Add Identity Provider. In the Add an Identity Provider, select Microsoft. In the Application Client ID, add the Customer Syndication Application Registration ID you copied earlier. For the issuer URL, enter the issuer of your tenant. For the client application requirement, choose Allow Request from Specific Client Applications and enter this ID. It's a fixed value for all Microsoft Android tenants. It is known as AZP Claim, and you can find it in our documentation. For the tenant requirement, select Use Default Restrictions based on issuer option. Make sure the required syndication is selected and save the changes. The Logic App will now validate and trust access tokens issued by Microsoft Entra ID and will no longer use the CIG parameter with its key. Before we close, here are a few tips. To debug your workflow, select Streamlog. It's a real-time logging capability available in Azure Logic Apps powered by Application Insights. For stateful workflows, you can track the HTTP calls to your workflow. To do so, select the workflow, and from the menu, select Run History. This video outlines the steps to build customer syndication extension using a zero-code approach with Azure Logic Apps. It demonstrates how to send a customer verification email and explains that this approach can be applied to other events like the on-token issuance start event for custom claims provider. Thanks for watching, and I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next video.